José Luis Smiley Scenes, born August 4, 1975, is an American gangster and former fugitive charged with 4 murders, rape, kidnapping, parole violation and unlawful flight to avoid prosecution. On October 19, 2009, he was named by the FBI as the 492nd fugitive to be placed on the list of FBI 10 most wanted fugitives. On November 22, 2012, he was found and arrested in Guadalajara, Mexico by the federal police. Was born on August 4, 1976 in Los Angeles, to a Maravilla gang member Mexican father and a Mexican mother who had substance abuse problems. He was their only child. He lived most of childhood with his grandmother in a small backyard bungalow on Ferris Avenue. He spent much of his time with his cousins at Pico Alizo housing projects. Scenes attended high school in Los Angeles Unified School District, but dropped out. Before the murders in 1998, the Scenes family had been evicted for an unspecified violation. Scenes, known by his nickname Smiley and fellow Cuatro Flats gang member Juan Pena, allegedly lured 2 rival East Los Angeles Tres gang members with a drug deal. Scenes allegedly shot and killed these unarmed 5 men, Josu Hernandez and Leonardo Ponce, execution style in front of 210 North Clarence Street in the Alizo Village area of Boyle Heights in Los Angeles on July 25, 1998. Ponce was shot in the chest, thigh and back, and Hernandez was shot 3 times in the head. The motive behind the murders is thought to have been retaliation for the assault of Pena by members of the same gang a week earlier. According to authorities, Scenes, who was on parole at the time of the shooting, fled from the scene and hid in the apartment of Sigrida Fernandez, his former girlfriend and the mother of his 2-year-old daughter. On August 5, 1998, Fernandez was kidnapped, allegedly by Scenes and his accomplices, and taken to Scenes's grandmother's house in an unincorporated area of East Los Angeles. There, Scenes told his grandmother to leave her own home. She later claimed that she complied because Scenes said he and Fernandez were trying to reconcile. 3 hours later, at 11 a.m., Scenes called his grandmother and told her not to come home, telling her he had just made a big mistake. She did, however, return to the bungalow, where she discovered the body of Hernandez in the back bedroom, sprawled half-nude with a bullet wound to her temple. Detectives found a Pilot .357 Magnum shells on a dresser and a note from Scenes: "The guys who drove me here, sick, have nothing to do with this." Scenes also wrote a message scrawled in pencil on the living room wall, in which he asked his grandmother to take care of his child and that he loved her. Hernandez has been speculated to have been murdered because she knew about Scenes's crimes. Shortly after, Juan Pena was arrested for the Clarence Street murders after a tipster placed him at the scene with Scenes. Pena, who was 14 years old at the time, was later convicted of 2 murders, despite the fact he was not the shooter. Possibly because of his fatal illness, he unexpectedly gave a detailed confession of the murders to authorities. He died of childhood leukemia at the California Youth Authority in 2001. In 1998, Scenes was charged with 3 counts of murder, 1 count of kidnapping and 1 count of rape, and a warrant was secured for his arrest. 6. Los Angeles City Council has offered a reward of $75,000 for information leading to the capture and conviction of persons responsible for those crimes. Despite the arrest warrant and reward, there were no other suspects or conclusive leads of Scenes's whereabouts until a decade later. In August 2008, 2 members of the Lot Stoner gang were stopped by a Missouri state trooper while driving a rental vehicle. A search turned up $610,000 in cash in a hidden compartment, wrapped and marked with the name Taro, which is now alleged to be one of Scenes's aliases. The money was confiscated by the police. One of the gang members was a 38-year-old breed trafficker, Oscar Torres, a friend of Scenes. On October 5, 2008, Anthony Lemon had agreed as a favor to Torres to drive 4 men in his Hummer limousine that night, picking up the first 3 and taking them to the Elephant Bar restaurant in suburban Lakewood. where they picked up scenes. Later, he ordered Lemon to drive to Montebello, then at 5 a.m. ordered him to drive to the limo owner's home in Whittier. Scenes was filmed on a home surveillance system arriving at Torres' house, chasing him out of his front door and then shooting Torres 4 times in the head, 6, possibly due to lost money. The DVD disc that had captured the shooting was removed from the surveillance system. However, shortly after the investigation of the homicide, video of the murder was retrieved from the security equipment's hard drive, leading investigators to identify Scenes as the shooter. Inside the home where Torres was murdered, detectives found Lemon, who had been shot in the back, but survived. 40 handguns and assault rifles, and a short rifle were found inside Torres' home. A month later, Scenes's cousin Johnny Prado was arrested for murder and attempted murder, and was sentenced to imprisonment for 26 years in November 2009. Additionally, Scenes is a suspect in a homicide that happened in early 1997. 5. Although there are rumors linking Jose Scenes to a kidnapping of a woman in Los Angeles and to the death of drug trafficker Bogart Bello for a failed drug deal in 2008, he has never been charged for those crimes. 4. Scenes was added to the list of FBI 10 most wanted fugitives on October 19, 2009, replacing another Los Angeles gang member, Emigdio Preciado, Jr. During the time that he was a fugitive, he was believed to have been living in Mexico, possibly working as an enforcer for a drug cartel and traveling across the Mexico-United States border using numerous aliases as well as legitimate identity documents obtained fraudulently. Scenes had been considered armed and extremely dangerous, and had vowed to kill police officers if they tried to arrest him in 1998. FBI had offered a reward of up to $100,000 for information leading to his capture. On November 22, 2012, he was found and arrested in Guadalajara, Mexico by the federal police while working for a Mexican drug cartel. After his arrest, Mexico extradited him to the United States. Scenes managed to elude authorities for over 14 years. Investigators revealed that after initially fleeing to Mexico, he continued to stay on the move, using as many as 20 aliases and moving throughout Mexico, Central America, the United States, and Canada. Upon being deported, Scenes bragged about his time on the run and even told authorities he had attended Los Angeles Lakers basketball games while on the run.